Now here live in New Orleans. It's Steeler football, and they have the lead as well as we begin quarter number four. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Now it's Roethlisberger. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Justin Hunter from 21 yards away. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. Boswell on now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Good hit there and knocked down hard near the 25. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because their confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Breeze will try again on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is emboldened a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Now Breeze on third down. Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. It's a gain of six on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Kill, kill, kill!
Now Breeze, gotta have this one. And this is incomplete. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Steelers, they're gonna take over an excellent field position. Now the Steelers' offense gets ready to get back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Cameron Jordan in there to bring him down for a loss of seven.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
This will be caught inside the 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. That goes for a gain of 31. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now Roethlisberger, and incomplete. Probably should have had that one, but with the game he's having tonight, maybe they'll let it go.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
This is Bell. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop it behind the line. They lost two there, and it's third down.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
He's got his tight end. That's James. Touchdown, Steelers. Jesse James, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. Boswell for the extra point. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. Boswell on now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. Mm-hmm. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Breeze to throw on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Breeze finding Snead there for a safe first down.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there, hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
10 yards still left on second down. Shotgun now for Breeze. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Throwing now is Breeze. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. He'll air it out deep for and for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off with great anticipation, and they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. After the interception, here's Roethlisberger. His throw incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. That'll bring up second down. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Second and 10. It's Roethlisberger once more. And this one caught by Hunter over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. He completes it to Hunter. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Offense in a good spot here, second and 2.
Tight end right, tight end right. Hey. Four down. Set! White 82.
Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. Complete to Bryan. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
Easy.
The Steeler first down, Roethlisberger to Bryan.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
There's Roethlisberger. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight. Roethlisberger gonna throw it. He's gonna rifle one deep left side. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Now Ben on third and long. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. And the Saints signal for another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Roethlisberger. Escaping the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And the Saints will have the football back. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Caught by Snead over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. That one goes for 24 yards. Breeze going to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it second down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
Again. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Mike Mitchell. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. Barry on to punt as he gets this one away. Now it's Ginn.
Whoosh.
And still fighting. Might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And possession will change here with very little time remaining in this contest. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. So after the INT, it's Breeze. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Back to the air on second down. It's Breeze. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Ryan Shazier, and he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. 6 interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it, but it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown 6 interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it 3 times. So Charles are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field. What an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout. And they're going to leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From New Orleans, good night, everybody.
miles on them like it's common sense. Hopped out the Benz like it's common sense. Put a monkey on my feet like it's common sense. Got gorillas in the streets like it's common sense. Stack the money heads up like it's second nature. Got a stay pulled up like it's second nature. Keep a chip in my hair like it's second nature. Big make me stare like second nature. Zeds disappear like second nature. On the same block. Off gentle, my stroke game mental, my lifestyle eventful. I didn't mean to offend you. Fendi belt saying I style like I'm mental, moving wild and mental. I made another five this week. Your money playing hide and seek. I don't even like to speak. I just tell him hi and bye. Slide up automatic, high and die, high and die, high and die. Doing styles on them like it's common sense. Hopped out the Benz like it's common sense. Put a monkey on my feet like it's common sense. Got gorillas in the streets like it's common sense. Stack the money heads up like it's second nature. Got a stay pulled up like it's second nature. Keep a chip in my hair like it's second nature. Big make me stare like second nature.
Still gonna do it, yeah, I haven't did it. I'm handling it, handy with it. Think I'ma do it, let that do it. Bang. Stick jam like what happened to it. Was it not working, bruv? Why you think I'm lurking, bruv? Creep on him, lean on him. Witnesses eavesdropping, keep popping. They keep bopping like I ain't seen nothing. Don't make me upset. Reach for an object. Who's that in the passenger? Brown skin, stopper. Got big body in my face on me. Money, I got that for me. You're not popping, never pop nothing. Stop bluffing. Your opinion always destined for brilliance. Wouldn't rest on a million. Dressed as civilians, all them masked up looking creepy. Park up, jump out, jump in, skirt out like it's too easy. If anybody else didn't see me,
doing styles on them like it's common sense. Hopped out the Benz like it's common sense. Put a monkey on my feet like it's common sense. Got gorillas in the streets like it's common sense. Stack the money heads up like it's second nature. Got a stay pulled up like it's second nature. Keep a chip in my hair like it's second nature. Big make me stare like second nature.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Carson Wentz's Eagles going up against Roethlisberger's Steelers.
Right at the convergence of the Three Rivers on Art Rooney Drive, we welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City. And a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Now a play fake here on first down. Dancing to his left. Oh, he's going to take it. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
Torrey Smith, 81 yards. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted, was it an audible, or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Sturgis out now to kick this one off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And a wildcat formation here. Out of the wildcat, a wide receiver carry. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
They'll let their receiver run it out of the wildcat. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down. Third down, Roethlisberger. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Brandon Graham, he's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of 5, and it'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, here comes a Steeler punter, Jordan Berry, to kick it away. Back deep is Darren Sproles. Pulled in at the 24. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And the Eagles will have great starting field position here as they take over. The Eagles offense back out onto the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Throwing is Wentz. Over the middle to Smith. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A very solid gain of 27. On that catch, he's already eclipsed 100 yards here in the first quarter. Charles, he's on pace for over 400.
And playing with great confidence, isn't he? I think he probably had it coming into the game, and now that he's really come out of the gate this strongly, I'd like to be in the huddle with him right now. You know he's demanding the football. And guess what? I throw it to him. He's having a fantastic game, and they haven't defended him yet.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of 10 yards on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. To throw, it's Wentz. Looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
Before they get it across the 20-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. And the back goes into motion. And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
A 1-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Roethlisberger will throw. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Nigel Bradham able to use that strength and get him for a loss of 2. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Now Roethlisberger to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Forced out to his left. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And this is something that you know that they're emphasizing, you know they're working on, but it has to improve. Carson Wentz lost 14 fumbles as a rookie. And the NFL's just different. When you're in the pocket, you're always at risk of that ball being jostled out.
And if memory serves, those 14 fumbles tied with Carson Palmer for most in the NFL.
In motion left comes Bryant. They'll start out on the ground with Bell.
And he'll take this one up to about the 23. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Halfback sent in motion. On second down, here's Roethlisberger, eluding the pressure right. The pass complete to Justin Hunter. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 53 yards. Sheds him off, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through.
And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. Jordan Hicks in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Nigel Bradham in there to get him, and this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. The swing pass caught, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone, and now it'll be fourth and goal. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. They'll run it with Bell. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Le'Veon Bell punching it in from a yard away. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. Started all even as the kick's away. This fielded at the 2. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. And out now come the Eagles. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Second down, here's Wentz. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Javon Hargrave breaking through to get him for a loss of 7. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
because they're moving them exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. Working from the gun, Wentz. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. They'll get 17 back there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Here we go on fourth down with Wentz. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. But he will not get away. He stops short of the marker. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. And a great spot to start this drive from here. Pretty awkwardly at the 29. It's a gain of a yard, and it takes us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. Second down following the run. And the quarterback is actually split out wide there in the Wildcat. Be knocked backward as he'll be marked down right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be third and 10 now. This time, Roethlisberger will throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. And he missed it. It's no good. And this game will remain tied here in quarter number two.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
On first down, Wentz. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Wentz to throw on second down. Finding some room at midfield. He finds Aguilar over the middle. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Give him 30 yards there.
Now, that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
Into the red zone, Wentz. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
to the air on second down. Wentz. Screen pass to Blunt. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. On third down, flush to his right, he dropped it, couldn't hang on in the end zone, so no 6 points, incomplete.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone, force the incompletion, force them into going for three and not giving up six.
And did it get there? Yes. Boy, he didn't get much of that at all. He tucked it just between the crossbar and the left upright. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Again, it's Bell. And he's got room. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And he's got this one just across midfield to the 49. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Here's Bell, and that formation won't yield much here as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go.
Here we go! Band 38! Band 38!
They'll try and run for it with Bell. Now Bell hit. He lost the football. Have recovered.
They may have the edge on the scoreboard, but that hasn't made them passive, has it? I mean, they dialed up a pretty good run blitz there, and Brandon, you know that all blitzes aren't just designed to get to the quarterback in the passer. Sometimes you're just trying to take away every gap, every hole that might be created in a running game, and they did it to perfection and caused a fumble there.
Took away the gaps, took away the holes, took away the football. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Wentz. They'll roll him out right. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Mitchell.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
It's Roethlisberger being chased out left, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Derek Barnett able to get in there and take him down for a loss of three.
On second down, Roethlisberger flushed out right. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham, and they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
On the toss, this is Blunt. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, that was a safety that came through and made the play, but there's no doubt in my mind, he hits like a linebacker, and we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time, we do indeed. A big hit for a loss.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Steps away to his... And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Ryan Shazier able to get in there and drop him behind the line.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Dancing to his left. This is caught. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A gain of 7 that time. Second and goal.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Shift together here from the D-line. From the gun, it's Wentz. And he'll score! Touchdown, Eagles! Carson Wentz, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles take advantage of good field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Timmy Jernigan in there to record another sack. Their sixth of the afternoon. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. He's going to air one out. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. It's a big play there for the Steelers. 54 yards. Man in motion right, Antonio Brown. On first down, it's Roethlisberger. And this is incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Second down now after the incompletion. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers.
Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Bryant with a catch right side. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. So they're operating in the red zone. First and goal from the 5. Now Bell. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Le'Veon Bell with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Steelers are able to make this a close game again. And it's good. It cuts it to 2. 16-14 our score. Back now in Pittsburgh. It's been a good one so far. Just a 2-point game here as we get set for quarter number 4. Well, on now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Screen pass to Sproles. And he's brought down after a good gain. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there, and on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
A really nice gain of 25 yards.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. Sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
And he's brought down. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
But he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
All right, so first down, 5 yards to go. Now it's Roethlisberger. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And some big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll bring up a second down. To throw here, Roethlisberger. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3. And they're going to go soft on the corners. And they'll put Bryant in motion left. Play clock winding down. Roethlisberger now to throw on 3rd down. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And he goes out of bounds inside the 10 at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
What would you have said to me if I told you in pregame that Big Ben and Antonio Brown wouldn't have hooked up until the second half?
I would say that they'd be losing, and they are.
Yeah, they are, and they've got to find a way now to continue to connect and try and get their team back in this game.
The slot man in motion right. They'll run it with Bell. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
And that's why you see so many teams play a 3-4 defense, because that set gives you a lot of flexibility about where to bring pressure from, and it's hard for an offense to pick it up. Left side, right side, up the middle, especially with some really flexible linebackers.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Now Roethlisberger to throw. And he slings one that's incomplete. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target. Third down here.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Forced out to his left. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So here we go. On now is the kicker, Chris Boswell. And his kick is no good. Oh, by the slimmest of margins, he missed it wide to the left. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, and you knock up too many attempts shorter than that one. I don't think anyone got a finger on it. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
The drive starts with a handoff to Blum. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Now it's Sproles. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively they burn it here with 1:51 left. The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in 4 tries. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. It's a sneak. It's Wentz. And he's got the at the 42. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Go Wentz to Blunt here. And some room to roam now. 31 yards there and a first down. Probably had 60,000 thinking pass right there, including us in the booth.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That was a big call, big guts on that one. And guess what? That run, it'll pay dividends.
Again, here's Blunt. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
They'll run it here with Blunt, and he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6. Wentz with a kneel down, and that will be the final act of this game. So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on 4th and 7. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility.